Okay, as you can see, we got another trio going here, but this trio, we've got a couple of veterans here. Dr. Mari.
Hi.
She's a veteran, yep, since she's been here now for, how long have you been here?
Almost 2 years.
Yeah. Okay, she's a veteran. And Jeffrey, or Jeff, with one F.
Morning.
Jeff with one F.
Now, he's also a veteran, and not just a veteran like... You know, he's been here a long time. He's been here twice now. You've seen two rounds of people mm-hmm. go through their transformations.
Yeah.
Not only you've seen people, but look at your transformation.
Yeah, I've been transforming and seeing other people transform. Just continues the evolution.
Jeff's from California, and he came up here to learn more, assist Dr. Mari. And just get acquainted to you know, these protocols, not even so much himself more, but to be able to see how effective they are too with other people. I look at this as a big clinical study when people come up here. Now, like I said, you've seen two rounds of people.
Mm-hmm.
One just left around 21 days. Okay. And then we had the 21 days when you came, what, 3-4 months ago?
Yeah. July, 4 months ago.
And this guy... He didn't go back to go ahead and get fat or to go ahead and actually devolve. He's really evolved since, if you see his last interview in the sauna, you know, looked the same. He gained about 20 pounds, okay? And he's not a fat 20 pounds. He's gained 20 pounds of muscle, which, of course, is what I call vital flesh, especially if you use it. A lot of people get muscle and they don't use it. It's just like stupid muscle. Okay, I see this guy exercise. He's super agility, okay? And he's got really fast reflexes. I see you on the ball, man. You're really fast moving around. So, you know, talk about just 2 seconds, because I like to go ahead and see a different perspective, because we see it all the time. We know, Dr. Mari knows, that everybody that comes here just about, only one person didn't do as good as we wanted him to do, only because he had a lot of emotional baggage. Okay? But the physicality.
Yeah, everybody gets better.
Massive.
Everybody improves. Everybody leaves with more than what they, you know, than what they thought they were going to get.
And they look 10 years younger.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody. Mm-hmm. Okay? And that's just the visual look. Now, you've been here, like I said, two times, two rounds. Tell us some of the... You know, things that you've noticed that really, that, you know, that you see that if you dry yourself out with water,
mm-hmm.
okay, and you let yourself actually reverse your energy, you can see how effective this is on everybody. Because normal doctors, remember when you see patients, 50% of the patients, they get better. 25% get worse, okay? And 25%, nothing happens to them. They just stay the same. Okay, now that's not the case here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and we don't treat disease here. I don't like to say that at all. We just manipulate terrains and let the body heal itself. Real simple. Body's intelligent. You've seen it. You don't have to do much. All you have to do is do little. Okay, it's a little bit different. You don't have to do much. You have to do little. Okay, so what do you think is the most like eye-opening? You know, not only you know this works. What is this? What is this? How is this changing your life? Because you're seeing that protocols that are very simple that people can follow. Other doctors can follow these. You can change people massively, massively. Okay,
yeah.
So you see a lot of sickness around the planet, so you see that these types of ideas are very valid, and people need to learn them more, because they are true. So just tell me what you think, just 2 seconds, as far as, remember, you've got this in your energy field now. You've got some tools that you really know that work.
Mm-hmm.
Not just you've read about. You've seen these tools work.
Yeah, they work on so many levels as well. You were talking about even athletic reflexes. I feel like my perception, my speed perception when I'm in movement, I can see a ball coming right into my hands, or I could kick a ball exactly how I want to kick it, or I can feel my individual muscles flexing as I'm running. It's like my brain is clean now too. So my perception, my body-mind consciousness is a lot more acute. And that's just athletically speaking. With the the skin cleaning and the steaming and the saunas, I feel a massive energy boost every time I clean my skin. And then apply the magnesium and the coconut oil and a little iodine, and it's outrageous. And when you have the extra energy, then you want to go and exercise.
Mm-hmm.
You don't have to go and exercise.
You
actually want to, and you almost need to.
Exactly.
Because you have this extra charge.
Extra charge.
Yeah. And a lot of people in the weightlifting or health world would be scared to fast for 2 weeks because they're going to lose their
muscle.
They're
going to get skinny, yeah.
They're going to lose their fitness.
Mm-hmm.
I did get skinnier, a lot skinnier, when I did my fast, but the rebound after the fast was unexperienced in my life. Gaining muscle easily, gaining endurance in my longer activities. My athletic performance has just increased, and I've been able to put on muscle and keep muscle and actually eat less, because it's my diet's so much more.
Your body's filled. Way more efficient.
Yeah, exactly.
Super more efficient. So, what he's saying too is that, it's really important, once you start to go ahead and actually take out a lot of different toxicity, because this is why you changed a lot, is because you did a 14-day water fast when you came here. Okay, that's pretty good. And you removed billions of particles of garbage swimming in your body, and you're just a young guy. You replaced tons of good, high-charge conductive minerals in your system. You exercised and you retrained your nervous system, and you rebuilt your gut wall flora. That's pretty smart. It's pretty simple. And look what it's done for you. In 3 months, it's been 3 months, right?
Yeah. August, September, October.
You put on 30 pounds, not 20.
Did you?
Well, I was down from my lowest.
Yeah, from your
weight
lowest.
Of fasting. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But no matter what, if you look at him, his whole physique is way thicker. And not only that, he's not like most people that gain muscle. Most people that gain muscle, the muscle that they gain, I call it stupid muscle. It makes them so they can't even touch their toes. Yeah, they're strong on the bench press, but they're not agile.
Yeah,
they've got all this extra muscle and all this extra meat and flesh because they ate a ton of flesh too, ate a ton of hormones in the flesh. And once you know that your muscles are 70% water, okay, why would you fear about cleaning up the water in your body? It's because, like you said, a lot of people think, like my dad says, how could anybody not eat for a week? You just did it for two.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we've done people here. 30 days was the biggest, that's just dry water. That's an accomplishment. It was a doctor in California, Japanese. And she said that the thing that really helped her is because we had a lot of sun back then. She laid in the sun every day for 4 or 5 hours.
Mm.
Okay. And as soon as she did, because she always had cravings before on the 21st day, 22nd, she didn't feel the greatest. Okay. And sort of low energy and so forth. But once she laid out in the sun, not for 20 minutes, she's out there for 4 hours. And she got so dark, and she was Japanese, and she said that the sun really would, before, would just tire her out. If you laid in the sun for 4 hours, you got to go to sleep. But when you're water fasting, basically what you're able to do is be able to grab other energy that's not even available. Okay, now you can see we're all sweating big time, okay? Big time. Big time. River sweating. Here's our temperature gauge, 140 degrees, and we've been in here 9 minutes because I set that time in the corner to 100. It's 91 right now. So when your pores are open, it doesn't take much to be able to let your skin really flow. So part one, what we're going to do here is just going to talk a little bit more until we get softer. But part two, what we're going to do is we're going to do a hydrogen peroxide wash with a scrub pad in the sauna. And this is really good to go ahead and actually not only clean the skin, that's one thing. We want to get into the pore. And this is where a lot of people come into the sauna. They don't sweat too good, okay? They're plugged. So, and you know this, how many people, when you know in the beginning, that come into the sauna, they don't sweat too good
yeah.
in the beginning?
Yeah, I always have people watch the time and figure out how long it's taking them to sweat.
Mm-hmm.
Some people come in here and it takes them like 15 minutes.
Just to get one drop.
Just to sweat. So like for us, probably five or less.
And this
minutes
is
minutes if it's really hot.
Yeah, and this is the way I like to go ahead and tell people. Okay, you can do it whatever way you want, but look, I'm river sweating. Jeff is river sweating. Dr. Mari's river sweating. And this is when you say, okay, I'm going to be in the sauna for at least 30 minutes, okay, when I start river sweating. You can't even count the first. If it took you 25 minutes to river sweat, then if you can, you have to go ahead and try to do the 30-minute marker. This is where they've done the research. It's actually, if you can river sweat for 30 minutes, remember, river sweat for 30 minutes. It's not being in the sauna for 30 minutes. Then it's like doing like a 3-day water fast. That's how much water you get a chance to go ahead and actually urinate through your skin, because that's what we're doing. We're urinating through our skin. And do you smell anything here? Does anybody stink? Okay, no. No stinkies. Okay, why? It's because once you put in good fuel in your system doesn't smell.
Yeah, but some people do smell. Some people get in here with us really, really, really smell.
I got to put coconut oil on with peppermint just to be able to hide to say you stink. Here, try some peppermint.
It's a nice way to say it.
It's a nice way to say it.
If you smell yourself, then you are toxic. Because, like, when I get back from the mainland and I, like, start eating raw again and, like, really being clean, I probably smell myself for, like, a week where I'm like, what is that?
Exactly.
You know, and it's like I'm just detoxing, but I think if you smell yourself in the sauna, like, it's a clear sign that you have some detoxing to do.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely. You know, I just got back from a trip. I was on the mainland in Peru for almost a month, and I've been back now for 1 month, and it's taken me about 1 month just to go ahead and feel okay from all the just eating out at restaurants. And if you eat out at restaurants, even if you try to eat vegetarian, try to eat as clean as you can, there's GMOs all over the place. All the cottonseed oil, okay, canola oils, all different types of things that basically are intermixed, you know. And once you clean out your gut wall flora, once you put in these GMOs, you find out your stomach just gets inflamed. Okay, so it's taken me about, and that's not just even the food that I ate, but it's taken me about a month just to get the toxicity from flying. Remember, 30 hours in the plane? You bet you there's a lot of radiation in the plane. You bet you it assaults your nervous system, okay, and your immune system. And going to, you know, places like Lima was like 1,000 times busier and dirtier than Los Angeles. But the cool thing was, I noticed that for some reason, no one was fat. So that sort of hit me in the head. Go to a place that's more toxic, and everything revolves around food in Peru. The most beautiful food they have there, the best of the best of the best. And, you know, I don't see fat people. And you know why? They don't have GMOs there. I asked them, "Do you guys ever seen a chemtrail?" They don't even know what it is. They've never seen one, okay? And when I was there for the 3 weeks I was almost there, I never saw one chemtrail. It never rained one day when I was there, and the skies were crystal clear every day, except for at Lima, when there's no sun for 6 months just because it's coastal fog. So, Dr. Mari.
Yes.
Now, you notice that when people do come, if you're going to come to the retreat, do you have like a protocol that you get them to try to adhere for, you know, before they even come?
Well, yeah, we definitely try to get, before you start a fast, it's best if you prime your gut by getting rid of meat, anything that's going to be like sticking in your intestine and rotting. I try to get people on a like whole foods, mostly raw, like mm-hmm. almost completely raw if you can, removing meat, removing dairy, removing wheat, corn, soy, those things, just getting yourself really clean. If people, you know, sometimes people have a hard time doing that. I have a lot of people who come here who are meat eaters, and so just getting rid of the meat is a difficult thing for them. And then to ask them to be all raw is really hard. But yep. as long as they can do it for a week before they come, I feel good about that, because then at least their intestine is a little bit... I'm trying to get the camera to stay.
Stay.
Because then at least their intestine is a little bit more primed, you know, and, you know, within that week, you're hoping that they get through all of the, like, you know, crap and meat. And obviously, they're not going to get all of it, and that's why they're coming here, and that's why we do, you know, colonics and all those things. But, yeah, that's how we prepare.
Trying to get them pre-clean them.
Prepare, yeah. I mean... You prepare by cleaning up the diet as much as is possible for you.
And the reason why I'm saying this is because, you know, a lot of people, you know, you have to understand, if you're going to come up here, then help us. Clean yourself up as much as you can before you get here, because the magic starts when you are clean-er. That's when the magic starts. The IV therapies, the colon hydrotherapy. Remember, we're not trying to wash out all the garbage that you ate before you came. We want you to have most of it out, so when you come here, actually can do some work.
Yeah, there was one guy recently who was going to come, and he didn't end up coming. Shocker. But he was like, I'm going to eat as much meat as I can before I get there. I'm just going to go to McDonald's. And I was like, I don't know if this is the right place for you. Mm-mm. Like, we want people who are, like, there's only so many spaces here. Like, we're not really looking for people who are going to come and, like, just half-ass and, like, always need somebody to kick them in the butt. Like,
And ruin the rest of the group.
Yeah, like, come, like, elevate your lifestyle, optimize your health, like, you know, have your motivation. Like, yes, like, Jeff, you know, Jeff's my intern. Like, we're here. We try to motivate people and we get them going. And, like, obviously we're here to support you. But it needs to come from within. You need to already have some kind of drive to help yourself when you come here. Because then you're going to get the most out of it. I find that the people who come here to optimize get the most. Like, Jeff, he came here to optimize. And I look at him months later and he's like...
Mm-hmm. Totally
on the path to like who he wants to be. Yeah. And physically, obviously it's easy to see that, but also like just how much he's changed, like with confidence and like with the spiritual path he wants to go in life too. Like, you know, we've like talked about it, and I think that that's a benefit that people reap from being here as well, you know. So mm-hmm.
100%.
I mean, it's not just the physical. I mean, you're a whole person. You're not just this like physical avatar, you know. So that, you know, I always get on my little spiel about that it's not just a physical detox. There's all of this other stuff going on. Your mental, emotional detox, you know, cleaning out your energy field, you know, being around all these amethysts every day,
yep.
sleeping in the energy of other people who are like-minded, clean, you know. Clean.
Everybody's on the same path.
Yep.
So what's happening is she's getting more picky and choosy when she talks to people on the phone, because we get lots of inquiries. And want to pick the right group to come up here. The ones that really, really are coming for a reason. Not because they're scared. They're coming here because, you know, they really want to change their world. Okay? And it's not just coming here for 2 weeks or 3 weeks or for a month and then going back to your old world. Come here for this, I call lifestyle transformation. And you're going to transform your life, but you first got to go ahead and take out the baggage in your closet. And that's simple work when, just like Neville said, 14 days water fasting. He says it was quite easy because the people around him supported him and everybody was on the same page. And he said, there's no way I could ever think about doing this at home.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. No way.
And, you know, like on the pre-dieting thing, you know, like Neville, for example, is a meat eater. And I don't know, I haven't actually asked him if he's planning on going back, but I did ask him yesterday.
I asked him, he said no.
Yeah, because you know, maybe you aren't able to stop on your own, but doing a fast like this will give you that restart button so that if that is a goal of yours or that's a desire of yours, you will be able to reach it and grab it. Like, whereas before it might have seemed like impossible, like how am I going to stop eating meat? But like you do something like this, it's like a huge change in your normal routine and your normal lifestyle, and so you're able to do that. Because I know yesterday I asked Neville, we were at the market, oh, what do you want to eat? Da, 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 you know, and I was like, hey, you haven't mentioned anything about me, you know? Like, have you missed it at all? And he's like, no.
And you're smelling it at the farmer's market because they're cooking, yeah, grilling, everything over there.
Yeah.
Yeah, and even if, like, you don't give up meat forever, or, like, you don't quit coffee forever, you come back just way more conscious about your consumption.
Mm-hmm.
And way less, like, fiendy, like, craving. Like, you'll eat it and be satisfied and be like, I might not even have needed to eat that.
Yeah.
Or drink that. Like, like I had a cup of coffee yesterday. And
so did I. I had some organic coffee at Abundant Life, my once a week.
Yeah. Yeah, and it was good, but
it bothered my stomach, though.
Yeah.
It did, just a little bit. I just know that
it's, for me, it's heavy. Yeah.
It's super. And if I do make coffee at home, if I do make it, I put a quarter teaspoon of sodium bicarbonate, or I use some coral minerals, and I use a pH of 10.5 water to be able to neutralize a lot of the acidity that's in coffee. It takes like 32 glasses of an alkaline-formed water just to break down the amount of acidity in just one cup of coffee. Same with a cola. So, you know, it puts a lot of stress on your internal minerals to be able to keep neutralizing all this garbage all the time that we put in, and we don't even understand that the drink we just had is going to take 32 glasses of water.
Okay,
and we're drinking water in here right now. I just want to show you my quick little brew. This is distilled water. I put a full squeezed lemon in there, really ground out the lemon. I put in a big heaping tablespoon of MSM in here, and about 100 milligrams of niacin.
Can
and
I some mineral. How do you drink this with MSM in it?
Oh, with the lemon, you can't taste it.
Really?
Yeah. No, you can't hardly taste it at all.
Okay.
Yeah. I found out by doing this for a while.
I just hate MSM.
No, me
so
too.
Terrible.
It tastes like fish.
Here, give it a try. Okay, and this is the secret to using MSM, because MSM, when I go into the sauna, I want the sulfur in my system. I want the sulfur because it helps me regenerate and replenish my system. It doesn't taste terrible. It doesn't taste so great, but it's not like you can't drink.
That's the best drink with MSM I've ever had.
MSM, oh my God. I've destroyed smoothies before adding MSM. Yeah. You're just like, oh, it's all ruined.
And I got a tablespoon, like a level tablespoon.
A tablespoon?
I have a heaping teaspoon, which is probably more than a level tablespoon, of MSM in here. A heaping teaspoon. So what we're going to do also, we're going to do a 3-gram dosage of
EDTA.
Ethylene diamine tetracetic acid. I wouldn't suggest anybody playing with this, okay, especially if you're taking it by the mouth, you got mercury fillings, okay, there's lots of different cautions to use when you use EDTA, which has 30,000 clinical studies. Remember, you can take this by the mouth. And I use this to be able to clean the intestines and to clean different portals. You can use most effectively for the body is through IV. And this is, we call Dr. Mari. She's the queen of puncturing people. Call her Samurai because she's good with a knife and a needle. And you can also use suppositories, which are also effective in a different way. So today we're going to use, this is dipotassium EDTA. It's a different form. And the dipotassium, when you take it by the mouth, is just not as aggressive on your intestinal tract. Because otherwise, if you take the other EDTA, you remember.
Disodium?
Yeah, it works.
Oh, yeah. Oh, my God, that was dead.
Remember that? Yeah.
It was crazy because it took, a whole 12 hours? I was like, oh, I'm fine. That was totally fine. No big deal. And then vomiting and shitting for the next,
and loving
until 3 a.m.
Loving the bathroom on the floor.
For 12 hours, I was vomiting and shitting. And, you know, this is what I thought was the craziest part. The craziest part was that after all of that, which was terrible, I, the next day, was like, maybe I should do some more of that. Mm-hmm. Like, it was just the strangest thing. I mean,
it's like
you can tell it's doing something good for you. Yeah, you can tell it's doing something good for you.
Well, and what we did was, too, remember, when you take this magical product, you don't just take it. You need to do deep body work. This is the effectiveness, and that's why you really had problems, because we worked on each other pretty hard there for a good hour. Okay, back and forth.
That was like the, you know, don't eat till dinner, then have shots with EDTA, then go for a hard workout, then come back and stretch.
Okay, so this is how much EDTA? It's about probably close to 3 grams. Or
I'm just gonna take it just like this.
Yeah, huh? Just take it like this. You don't have mercury fillings.
Is there water in here?
No, you didn't bring any water?
I have some out there.
Oh,
but,
okay. I was going to say, fat girl, you're supposed to always bring your water.
This is intense right here.
Yeah.
I just put it on my tongue.
Yeah, just make sure you don't swallow the powder down.
Swear it. And then you don't can take swallow a, it?
No, I mean, inhale the powder down because it'll choke you. You know what I mean?
Do you swish it? Or just...
Yeah, swish it around. Okay. There's her dose. Dose-a-roli. And EDTA, specifically, tell them about what EDTA does. Here's Jeff's dose. Okay.
EDTA is a chelator. So.
There we go, Jeff.
Chelator means it removes not only heavy metals, but other inorganic compounds that are in your blood.
Now it's my turn.
In your tissue, because many times these things are stored in your tissue, because they're toxic in the blood, so your body is like, okay, how can I get this out of danger's way? So in your blood is where it's dangerous. So your body stores things in the tissue really tight. Heavy metals sometimes are stored in the bone, the organs, just any tissue that your body can get it in to get it out of the blood so that it's not making you toxic. So anyway, chelators remove those things. So the most recent literature for EDTA, like chelation the way that I'm doing it here, IV, which is disodium EDTA, is to clear the arteries and vessels. They're actually using it in place of putting in stents. So a stent is something you have placed in an artery that's clogged. They go in there and put this like wire mesh that opens a little hole. Mm-hmm. Obviously that doesn't help anything because then you just get a, you know, you
no
get
change
a clog
of diet,
somewhere
not
else.
Really helping people. The EDTA is beautiful because it's.
I mean,
non-
if you have a clogging in your plumbing, you don't just go in there and like put a wire mesh to expand the crap.
Exactly.
You go in there, you take out the tubes, you clean, you get all the crap mm-hmm. out of there.
So EDTA is really good too. Remember, our intestinal tract is loaded full of pesticides, insecticides, herbicides, all different types of chemicals. Whatever you have in your food, whatever you breathe, okay, whatever you drink. It has to pass through the intestinal tract, and then it lets it in into the body. And a lot of times our enterocytes, our gut wall flora, our intestinal, the cells in there are just clogged. So this works really good to loosen the house. And there's a variety of different, what I call, solvents to be able to do this with. This is more for heavy metals.
Yeah, so this one, taking it by mouth is different because it's interacting with your, like you're saying, your enterocytes, your intestinal cells. Mm-hmm. Whereas like when you do it IV, you're really more like cleaning the blood.
Systemic, yeah.
Yeah, and you're going to the cells via the blood. So this way, I mean, you're still going to the cells via the blood, but you're having to digest all the EDTA, so it's also cleaning.
I found
this
super beneficial to do all three.
Yeah.
Is to attack it from all three levels. Remember, a lot of people that have prostate problems, that's why doing the suppositories in that area right there is because the prostate's right there too. You want to get EDTA if you can. Localized. Problem is it's not easy to localize in certain spots. So, how'd that taste?
Didn't taste too bad, actually.
Nah. I know, I was expecting something much worse.
Well, the calcium disodium is salty. And the dipotassium, it's like...
Nothing.
Okay. All right, didn't feel much. Didn't taste much. Hope it does something. So, we've been in here now 26 minutes, and we've probably lost, I don't know, a pound and a half of water so far. Okay, so that's why we want to...
I'm not sweating as much as you guys.
Yeah, well, you need more water, too, consistently. Go get your water. She's going to go outside. And... the idea to doing any of the sauna, remember, is you got to have
Want that jar right there?
You have to have a lot of water in you before you even get in here. Very important, okay? Your body can't sweat unless it's got water. And once it stops sweating, it just means that you're not drinking enough water. Remember, the number one disease on this whole planet is a very simple disease. It's called chronic dehydration. So before you come in here and get dehydrated more, make sure that you hydrate yourself not only before you get in here, but once you get in here, you want to try to drink every couple of minutes, a few swallows. So, and then when I get out of here, I drink the same amount right here within about 20 or, yeah, within about, this is 64, within about 30 minutes. Okay, so.
It's not 64.
I think so. It's 58. 58, no,
this
it is
40.
That's a 40 right there.
This is a 40.
Oh, that's 40? This was supposed to be, I'm wrong. Whatever it is, that amount of water, which is a lot. That's probably about 30 or 40 sips. So important the rest of the day too. Remember, your idea is try to move the fluid. So today's spa day for me. Let me just tell you my little morning workout that I've already done. I've cleaned my skin, okay, with alcohol before I get in here, because I want to open up my pores as much as I can, so they're just open. They're just going to flow. There's nothing impeding them. I did put coconut oil on. I put magnesium on and a little bit of cacao butter. I like to use that every day on my whole body. I went ahead and flossed all my teeth. I spent about 15 minutes, and I put a little bit of diatomaceous earth, a little MSM, a little sole salt, and sodium bicarbonate, and I floss all the upper parts of the teeth. I do something every week. This is my spa day, remember. I'm going to take care of myself. Last week, I cleaned the insides of my ears out, and I don't use Q-tips, but I used hydrogen peroxide, and I used a spoon to spoon out this really nasty stuff that comes out. Remember, no Q-tips. And I did an enema this morning. I told everybody, I said, don't worry, I'm going to wash my hands before I get in here.
I was like, oh, you're doing an enema. That's great. That's great.
Exactly. She texted me this morning at 6:40. I said, I'm going to do my enema first. Let's meet at 7:45. So the enema is super beneficial if you want to really clean out the colon. And it's not just by using water. I put 60 ounces of a pH of 10.5. I used two, and this is what I do. Remember, this is more advanced. Got to go ahead and try things. Do them on a very...
Just do a little bit at a time.
Yeah, do a little bit at a time. And I used 3 tablespoons of magnesium chloride minerals, 2 heaping tablespoons of sodium bicarbonate, 1/2 teaspoon of activated charcoal, and 1 heaping teaspoon of MSM, and 1 teaspoon of sole salt. And that's a very, not aggressive enema, but it's going to go... in the body completely different than just using water. So these are solvents, and I like to be able to neutralize. The activated charcoal takes out poisons, the MSM neutrophies, the sodium bicarbonate dissolves acids, and you wouldn't believe the stuff that comes out of you that's sort of stuck inside you. So it's nice to do an enema, and then maybe next week, instead of me doing an enema, I'm going to do an enema by the mouth, and I'm going to use pretty much the same type of solution with different quantities. Okay, and I'm going to put these materials down this way, and I'm going to clean the first part of the intestinal tract, just like we're doing now with the EDTA. So these are all little treatments. Remember, practice on yourself and watch the videos we have. I have lots of videos at Earther Academy on how to do an enema with different solvents and different various disciplines. I do a headstand as soon as I do my enema, and I go do a headstand right away so I can get the fluid to go ahead and go deeper inside my intestinal tract. So, you
it's
know,
fun. It, really fun.
Yeah, once you do one or two of them, you're sort of a pro at enemas, but if not, you're going to have some enema bloopers, so watch it. And don't leave your toilet too far. Think of you got about an 8-foot leash to the toilet, because, and when you have to go really bad, you'll see in the videos that we do, I jump up and down and really try to hold it, but I'm right next to the toilet with the seat down ready to go. But I try to hold it as long as I can, as long as you can. And then when you're done, we have a protocol to be able to massage the visceral, the lower intestines. So what you're trying to do is actually get out as much accumulated waste that's in your intestinal tract, and then re-flourish with probiotics afterwards too.
Yeah, can I just make a comment about visceral massage? So like... I have a friend who's in DO school, and he got to go see a surgery that I got. They were cutting out a part of this man's intestines. And he asked, how do you, like, know that that part of the intestine is dead? And he just flicked it like that, and the part of the intestine that's alive will, like...
Move.
Yeah, it will like, move like that. And so, like, reflex. When you're just doing a light massage in your abdomen, like, it is moving your intestine. So... Visceral massage is super, super, super effective. It's super simple and easy, but it's amazingly effective. Just like castor oil packs, just like some of these like therapies that are ages old, you know, but oh, they're too like, you know, they're too simple to work. But these things are really, they're really effective doing the visceral massage.
We have new technology. We have a pill to do everything that you don't need to do anymore.
You don't have to rub your belly.
And that's a big mistake. So, you know, it does take work to what I call not only detoxify yourself, but it takes more work to rejuvenate yourself. So this is why I like Jeff. Jeff is, you know, he's a super active guy that inspires everybody here to want to exercise. He's instead of like a cow or a sow, okay, which really don't run anytime unless there's food or someone's going to hurt him. He's like a gazelle. Everywhere he goes, he wants to, you know, move. And he's always doing something, which is telling you about his energy field. And his energy field is sometimes uncomfortable maybe to some other people. Why? Because their energy field's so lazy, making them feel bad. Mm-hmm. Okay? And you're not showing off because some people, he's showing off. No, he's not. This is part of your day, is to exercise, if you can, a few times a day. And it's better off to do short versions of exercise than long, drawn-out 2 or 3 hour sessions. Don't burn yourself out.
Definitely. I was going to say before, like, I gained a lot of muscle, but really all I've been doing is calisthenics. And I don't do, like, a lot at a time.
Yeah, Jeff's actually a pretty lazy guy.
Pretty lazy guy, actually, when it comes down to it. But I'll do, like, one to two sets every hour, the whole day. And that just keeps my energy up, and it keeps me wanting to do the next set. And when I feel low energy, I'll do another set, or I'll go for a little mini sprint. Mm-hmm. I use exercise for energy, not the exact opposite.
Exactly.
Not to tax the system.
And I watch him out there. He's up in the morning, and he's doing squats, jumping up like a little kid. Okay? And this is... The smart thing to do is to use your body, not so much even going to the gym, is to use and learn how to master the motion of your body and use your body as a tool. Okay, most of the stuff you do, you may get a little couple dumbbells, a couple this or that, but you don't really need a gym right now because you've advanced yourself that you can now use your body instead of use linear pushing, you know, machines, which really grow you only in that straight line. When you're doing your exercises, you're doing dynamic motions. You're never really doing anything the same thing twice.
Yeah, and if you want, like, bigger shoulders, do some handstands. I mean, like, those things are one of the greatest workouts known to man
for
balance and strength. You don't need to be throwing around the dumbbells and the barbells so much.
Okay, so we've been in here now. We're pretty warm right now. We're going to start part two in a sec. And like I said, we're going to do a hydrogen peroxide scrub. And there is a technique to doing this. And this is to, like I said, not only open up your skin pores, but our pores are really running right now. Look at Dr. Mari. She's got the drip going down. Look, river. Okay. So it's not that our pores are clogged. It's just that this is a treatment I do once in a while. And the only thing you want to do is make sure I'm just using... 3% stabilized oxygen. I just got this at Costco. I'm not going to ingest this, though. But the best way to do is use 3%, 5%, or even 7% hydrogen peroxide food grade. But this is the 3%. But what we're going to do is we're going to use some different types of tools to open up the skin and really get this inside. And this is to cleanse the pores. And this really, really makes you feel like you didn't get a bath. You just feel like you just lost 5 years.
I'm excited.
Yeah, no, this is beautiful.
I think this EDTA is like hitting me or something. Feeling like antsy in here.
Yeah, she's getting giggly. Good. Okay, so anything you want to add before we go to part two?
No, I'm looking forward to doing the skin cleaning. I've never done the hydrogen peroxide before in a sauna, so it's new for me.
Okay, so, you know, as far as, remember, Dr. Morris, he supervises this big protocol here. And over the last, like I said, almost 2 years, we've been flexible to add anything that makes sense to this program that actually makes sense. So... We feel right now that it's a nice, diverse program. You know, you've got all these different sections to be able to make space so you can put in a lot of the good stuff, but taking out a lot of the garbage and letting your body fix it and heal itself. Yeah. So,
really going on the philosophy that, you know, we're living in excess, not going with the regular allopathic philosophy that we're missing something or we're deficient in something all the time and that we need to put more in. And so we're going more on the, you know, this excess society that we're living in and just giving our body that time to relax, but also incorporating the mental, emotional, also incorporating the physical, the exercise, the IVs, the skin cleaning. You know, there's just so much that we've added to it. And then teaching people how to come into their new, more upgraded life and really feeling that they have the tools when they go home. Like Jeff, when he went home, made all the ferments, made kombucha. Like,
got
you know,
a zoodler.
He's like texting me for like raw taco recipes and like, you know, so.
Start a new life.
Like, you're able to do it. You don't feel so because maybe right now to you it might seem so difficult to start fermenting or start making kombucha. It might seem kind of daunting, and you know,
raw food might seem
like so foreign. But after you've been here 21 days, you go home and you're like, okay, it's not so bad. It's not hard. I just Google a recipe and I just do it.
She whips up a dinner for 8 people in what, 30 minutes?
Less.
Even. Okay.
I mean, easy.
It's not hard. And does it taste good? It's the best Always. Stuff that anybody, once your body doesn't have this yeast, mold, and fungus invasion, these foods really taste good. But if they don't taste good to you right now, once you clean yourself up, this will be the food that you'll only want to crave.
I mean, the food is good. Yeah, not too bad and hard, but I mean, like, we're eating really clean, great, healthy, raw food. I mean, it really nourishes you. Like, we eat one meal a day here, and everybody's always super sated and like,
rounded.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Anything you want to say there, Jeff?
Just having a party, Sunday party in the sauna
Sunday
with my
party.
Two besties.
So, you know, just a little bit of inspiration for other people that are scared to be able to actually clean themselves up. Do you, I mean, in your mind, in your opinion, do you feel that that any of these techniques that anybody can learn and do are mm-hmm. essential or beneficial?
Yeah, they're essential, beneficial, and the thing is that they're really easy, actually, once you start implementing them. Like mm-hmm. the vodka skin wash, seeing the dirt come exactly. off of your skin is just like such a like a aha light bulb moment that you'll begin to clean your skin after you just do it once. And making kombucha one time where all you do is make a sweet tea and then get a culture and put it in a jar and it's then you have kombucha.
It's like three steps literally.
Making sauerkraut and you cut cabbage and put in salt water. And that'll cost you $30 at the store. It's simple and it's effective. Those fermented foods like give you energy and while cleaning you out.
Well, that's the best part of people redoing it, is because once you drink the kombucha, once you've done these few simple things on your own, like even make your own garden, mm-hmm. that's it. All of a sudden, you get your health back. Simple. Because it makes you feel so good. So
doing it is, like, it gives back to you. Like, it's an art to have your own garden. It's an art to make your own ferments. You know, it's like an art taking care of yourself. So you feel accomplished when you help yourself.
100%. Here's some of the tools we're going to use. These are tools that we specially make at Earthshift. This is sort of like a steamroller, and you can see it's got little noogies on there. And this is like an acupunctural pressure point. But this works beautiful to open up the skin. We'll show you how to use that. And then we have our traditional different spoons that we're using. Okay, this is a very sharp blade. This is a very dull blade. Okay, and this is to go ahead and dig deeper into the tissues. This is to get more of the superficial pores. And this is something that we designed here to be able to simulate this tool. And this is a rib, because this works so good to be able to get into the nooks and crannies. Problem is, you can't find fossilized ribs too easy, so had the guys go ahead and make this one. You can see how this edge right here is used as a tool. This edge right here, you can see, is very thick. Okay, it's used as a tool. You can use the top of this as a tool, and the top piece is this. It's got a little groove right here, and this is for doing knuckles, turning it sideways. This is a basic tool, okay, but it's an essential tool. Basic meaning that this does like five things in one. It's not like a specific tool. Okay, let's get started. 40 minutes exactly now.
Okay.
Whew. You feel like you're warm? I do.
Yeah, I'm just starting to feel warm. Mm-hmm. And then you open the door and I'm like, oh, okay.
Exactly.
Are we going
to restart? Okay, here we go. Part two coming up.
important reminder. All information and ideas are for informational purposes only and are in no way intended as medical advice or as a substitute for medical counseling. Earthshift Products, Dr. Robert Cassar, all of their partners, affiliates, and subsidiaries will not be held accountable for the use or misuse of the information presented therein. This information is not intended as medical advice. The authors, publishers, and speakers of this work are not medical doctors and do not recommend the use of mineral-deficient foods, drugs, or medicines to achieve beauty and to alleviate health challenges. Because there is always some risk involved, all persons involved with the development and distribution of this information are not responsible for any adverse effects or consequences of any kind resulting from the use or misuse of any suggestions or procedures described on our website or Earthshift Live radio talk show or therein.